Hello， 大家好，牛年好啊！首先祝大家在新的一年平安顺利啊！我想春节过后咧，随着我哋春天的步伐越来越近，大家都很关注我哋经济复苏的问题，所以呢一期的节目咧，我请嚟加拿大小型企业及进出口促进部部长伍凤仪女士咧，嚟同大家倾倾政府有啲咩措施咧，帮助我哋中小企业嘅。Hi Mary， how are you？
Hello Patrick， 我想祝大家新年快乐。
Hey, very good. Well, let's say, you know, as a minister, right, for a small business, you know, can you tell us what the federal government is doing, you know, to support a small business when so many are locked down because of this pandemic time, right?
Yeah. You know, Patrick, small businesses really are the backbone of our economy. Right. Everywhere around the country, our small businesses are so important.As you know, I myself grew up in a small business growing up here when my parents first came to Canada from Hong Kong. So I know how hardworking small businesses are, but also how difficult it is right now during the pandemic. And I want to thank small businesses because they are doing their part to help all of us stay safe. So we have, as a federal government, from day one, decided that we needed to support Canadians and our small businesses. So you hear a lot from businesses that they need to keep their staff. They need to pay for things like rent. They need to have some working capital because the bills continue to come. So we have put out emergency support programs to help businesses keep their employees on staff. That's helped almost 5 million people stay working. And then the small business loan, that's helped over 830,000 businesses across the country. So we know that these supports are helping businesses, but that's our commitment. We've always said, we're going to be here with small businesses. We're going to help you bridge to the other side of COVID-19 so that we can work together on the economic recovery.
Understand, yeah. Well, from your portfolio, also include export promotion and trade. Can you tell us a little about any initiative you are taking in this area?
I always say that my job is start up, scale up, and access new markets for Canadian businesses. And during COVID-19, even though there have been shutdowns and even though businesses have not been able to travel, we have, at the federal government, put forward virtual trade missions. So we have continued to do the work to help our businesses try to access those customers in the international marketplace. So we have done two, and there will be more to come. We did one to South Korea, and we did another one through the European Union. And for the European Union, we did a business summit that was over 3 days, and it was to celebrate the third year anniversary of Canada's trade agreement with the European Union. We have 14 free trade agreements all around the world. And really, what are those agreements about? It really is to help our businesses grow and to access those international markets. So we continue to do the work to help promote Canadian businesses who want to do business internationally, and also supporting those businesses who are working internationally to make sure that they are supported through our trade commissioner, so that if they're experiencing disruptions and so forth because of COVID, that they are getting the help that they need.
Understand. But there's one special question that a lot of Canadians might be interested in particular with what happening to the repay trade relation with the USA, right? Now that Donald Trump is out of the office now, is the government going to try to change Biden's mind about the Kingston XL pipeline?
Well, I think that, you know, the government, our government has been very, you know, sort of have said that that we are very disappointed with this decision, of course, and we absolutely understand how this impacts the energy sector, in particular the workers in the energy sector. So I want the workers to know that absolutely we are with you. But I would also say that that between Canada and US, we have a long and deep relationship. The Prime Minister was the first call that the US President made. And in that conversation, the Prime Minister was very clear to advocate always for Canada's interest and to remind our American friends and neighbors how integrated our supply chains are and this history between the two countries. But even if you look at the $5 hamburger, a $5 hamburger is made from Alberta beef, It gets processed in the USA. The bun is baked in California, but with Saskatchewan wheat, and it may have lettuce that might be from Arizona, and the tomato is from Ontario. So, you know, even in a simple hamburger, you see the relationship and the cross, you know, the integration of those supply chains. So it's very, very important that we continue to work on this market and that Canadian businesses and our workers continue to have access to this very preferential market. And I do believe that there are many areas that are in common. I mean, Canada is the largest customer to 32 US American states. We are bigger customers than Japan and China and the United Kingdom put together. So Canada and the US are important partners, and we're going to continue. And I certainly am looking forward to speaking to my counterpart once she is confirmed to make sure that we continue to advocate for Canada's interests, our business interests, our exporters' interests, because it really is beneficial for both the US and Canada.
Well, let's switch our focus from the whole country to right here in Markham. Can you tell us about the expansion of the Paya Tourism Foundation Community Center?
Yes, that was a very lovely announcement that I was able to make just last week. We are investing together with the province, but also Paya Community Trillium Foundation on an expansion of that very important community center. Of course, it's right at, in Thornhill. It's in Markham Thornhill, it's in my riding, but it's a terrific community center that is welcoming of many Canadians, Iranian Canadians, but many, many diverse communities in Markham. And they are getting, they're getting over, I think, $1.8 million of investment by the federal government so that they can expand the really terrific community presence and center that they have. But this is in collaboration with our provincial colleagues, and also, of course, in support of Paria.
I gotta say, you have worked hard for our community, for a lot of things. Wow. Outside of your portfolio, right? But of the great interest to our viewers, is the government doing anything to combat anti-Asian and other forms of racism?
The answer is yes, and we will keep doing it. And I, along with the Prime Minister, and indeed our entire government, stands against it. For Lunar New Year, we hosted an event that brought together many, many people in the community. And the Prime Minister was really clear, as have I been, we must stand up against racism in any form at all. And I want to assure Asian Canadians, the contributions that you all make to Canada and the diversity and the multicultural nature of our communities, it is what makes us so strong as a country. So I'm very proud to be an Asian Canadian female cabinet minister around the decision-making table, along with Prime Minister Trudeau. But we must always stand up against racism of all form, and certainly anti-Asian racism. There's no place for it.
That's correct, yeah. Well, based on your federal government, the one and only Chinese, minister. So how do you see our Chinese community, react on this pandemic time? A lot of people be stay home for over a year now. So is there anything that, from your end to try to, advise those people how they deal with their life, how they deal with the future?
Yeah, I want to say to people, on the one hand, I want to say thank you. And on the other hand, I want to say, please keep it up. And I say thank you because what we really all are fighting is COVID-19, mm-hmm. and to stop the spread of COVID-19. And I know how disruptive this has been to people's lives and how hard it has been. Now, we do see a light at the end of the tunnel. We are going to be vaccinated. So I want to thank Synflex for giving me this opportunity to have a bit of a conversation like this with all of you and your viewers. And to everyone, I would say, just keep it up. And the last thing maybe that I will end with is, I've also seen in talking to so many Canadians that this period has been difficult. And the difficulty also creates, it's a strain on mental illness and on many people's ability to cope. And in here, we also have supports as a government in a hotline a wellness hotline that I'll be sure my office sends you the link for, so that Canadians should know they aren't in this alone, and certainly Asian Canadians should know that they're not in this alone. But I'm so proud of our community. I'm so proud that during this time, I've seen such incredible volunteerism from, you know, young people delivering food to seniors, community groups who have gotten together to help those that are vulnerable. And I've seen the best of Canadians, and I've seen the best of our community. So I want to say thank you, and to keep it up. There's still some work we need to keep doing, to keep listening to public health officials, but I know we are going to get through this together.
Thank you so much for your time, Minister, and I'm very, very, very happy, you know, to have a chance to discuss. Look forward for more opportunity.
Thank you so much to you, Patrick, and San Lin Fai Lo to everybody. Xin Yin Kuai La.
Okay, thank you.